It feels amazing, really good, yeah.
For people who aren't familiar with the game, can you just tell us a little bit about Size Does Matter? A provocative title, nonetheless.
Oh, yeah, we get a lot of stupid stuff in our spam email, thanks to that title. Okay, so Size Does Matter is basically an Twitch arcade rhythm game where every obstacle that comes towards you is timed with the music. So you steer this little block going through gaps of other blocks, and the bigger you are, the more points you get, thereby Size Does Matter.
It's a simple but hopefully addictive idea. Where did it come from? Where did the inspiration for the game come from originally?
Okay, so as I said on stage, Super Hexagon is probably one of the most biggest inspiration. Without Terry Cavanaugh and Super Hexagon, Size Does Matter would never have existed. So that one, Tetris, a lot of music games basically, Step Mania, Beat Mania, Guitar Hero, Bitrip Runner, a lot of music games, and Tetris, of course, Tetris. So basically our game is a combination between Guitar Hero and Tetris, so... All music games.
What do you think it is about the combination between the kind of simple functionality of those games and music that captivates gamers so much, and in some respects more than even the sort of massive studio productions?
Yeah, I think mostly that big. I think that bigger studios try to make like 40 things good, but we try to make maybe two or three things good. We don't want to overscope anything. We want to have one mechanic or even. Maybe two mechanics, and just try to make them as perfect as possible. And I think that's what makes things and games addictive, because you have small things that are really addictive, but you can't make 40 things addictive at once. So I think the focus of the design is the most important thing.
It's so many indie companies right now, and they are growing. There's popping up more everywhere, and also different countries are more involved because the indie. Companies are coming to like events like these and such, and they are nominated and they make great games. So I think that the diversity is really important for the games industry.
I mean, looking to the future, do you think that the new technology, the new consoles in particular, open up more possibilities for independent gaming?
Yes, probably. I think the big companies have kind of like opened their eyes to what indie companies can make. And even just small teams that aren't really professional or anything, they make great stuff, and it's like the talent that you have to watch out for. And I think the new consoles will bring that to the light. Yeah.